Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today we are talking about the absolutely impossible upgrade that I just went through for Bevy 0.8. So right here, we've got Block Breaker, right? And if I click and play the game, if I remember the controls, you can see that the ball goes up, the paddle gets hit, the ball goes up, the paddle gets hit. And, you know, there's a couple of bugs like this. The paddle can go outside of the scene, but we've got all of the debug collisions for the Bevy Rapier 2D plugin. We've got the capsules falling that clearly I had had them not despawning, but they spawn. And if I had remembered to hit that before, then it would have spawned three balls. The power-ups still work. And now the ball has disappeared and everything is great. We're going to upgrade Block Breaker to Bevy 0.8. And the thing I didn't tell you is that this is actually already on Bevy 0.8. And this surprised me. This really surprised me. But we'll get into why it surprised me. So Bevy 0.8 has been out for almost a month now. See, the release notice was placed on July 30th on a Saturday. It's been about 3 weeks. I think that the things that I was most interested in were the new material system. And then there's also camera-driven rendering. Which we cover in some of the other videos. So the big TLDR is it's easier to write GPU shaders now, both vertex and fragment shaders, as well as compute shaders, which we've been getting into lately, which is super fun. I think that the material upgrades are one of the reasons that I am even writing shaders right now. And then camera-driven rendering is also pretty cool. So that's involved with the render graph. The render graph is something that we're getting into a little bit more with the compute shader, so I'll leave that for that. Basically, Bevy 0.8 is wonderful. So what did I do for, Bevy is pre-1.0. What did I do for such a breaking change, right? Like the Bevy 0.7 to 0.8 upgrade happens, and obviously it's pre-1.0, so they're still building things, right? So some things are going to break. And then obviously, like, what else do I have in here? I have not just Bevy, but I have like five other pack crates or packages or whatever. So I've got Bevy, Bevy Asset Loader, Bevy Prototype Leon, IS Loopless, which is a prototype of a PR that is going to be merged into Bevy at some point. Kayak UI, which I'm literally pulling in from a Git repo. And then Bevy Rapier 2D, which is the all of the physics and collision-y bang, crush, folly stuff. So I've got quite a few things in here, and like it's not a small project. It's not a large project either. But if I just clock it and I can read these numbers, well, in any case, it says language files, blank, comment, and code. So we're looking for the last number. This is about 1500 lines of Rust. It's not that much, but it's over 1000. It's like 10 files. It's not a trivial amount of code either. So what did I do when I went, hey, I want to upgrade? Well, as you may have guessed, I may have went, F it. And I literally just, I upgraded everything all at the same time. I did no special upgrade process. I didn't upgrade one thing at a time. I didn't prepare. I bumped all the version numbers. I bumped this to the revision that just happens to be on the main branch right now, hoping it would still work. And I want to show you all the changes that I had to make, actually, because it's incredible in my mind. Let's see, there's the cargo.lock, right, which is going to have a ton of changes. So let's not include that. So let's do a git diff on the source directory. So the first thing is Bevy Asset Loader has a prelude now. So if you use Bevy Asset Loader before, I was importing Asset Collection and Asset Collection app, and I just had to swap that for this line to get those things to come back in. And I changed literally zero other code in this file. The other thing is related to the camera-driven rendering PR, which was a big PR. It did a lot of stuff. It made some things nicer and whatnot, right? But I still only had to change these 8 lines. And instead of having an orthographic camera bundle, we now have a camera 2D bundle. And the orthographic projection uses a scale of 2, just like before. And the transform is the board pixel size over 2 and the board pixel size over 2. And then I don't know why I chose 1000. It's a number, but it's the same number as before. So that's it. And that's it. That's it. We changed one kind of used path, one module path, because now Bevy Asset Loader has a prelude. And we updated the camera's syntax And the entire game, everything, including the UI, including Kayak UI, which is literally being pulled from a Git repo. Who knows when I last updated that? It works. The game's still playable. It runs, and I didn't have to do anything else, which is absolutely, I don't know. I've spent a lot of time in some other programming ecosystems where like that is not a thing that happens. I feel like in other ecosystems that I write quite a bit of code in professionally, this upgrade would have been horrendously painful. And I was just so surprised that this was painless. This was just literally painless. I bumped all of the versions and I hit go. And then I had to change two things. That's it. So anyway, I wanted to share that with you because I was like, I was going to make this whole video and I was going to be like, this is how you upgrade. And it turns out that how you upgrade is by bumping the version. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope that this shows you a little bit about the kind of differences in the way that Rust ecosystems treat their projects. Like, don't get me wrong. There are crates that break, right? There were breaking changes in this bevy release that is to be expected, especially until they hit 1.0. There are other crates that need to make more breaking changes. But overall, in my experience, the sort of stability and the ability to just upgrade your crates and your third-party dependencies is incredible in the Rust ecosystem. So I just wanted to share that with you, and I will see you tomorrow for the next video. Have a great rest of your day.